Hi all, in this video, let's learn about rules of hooks in React. So we may heard about use state, use effect and many more hooks, but we need to understand its rules before using them. So let's understand those rules. So at first, there would be two rules for the React hooks. So the first rule is only call the hooks at the top level. It means don't call them inside the loops, conditions or nested functions. So let's see that. What does it mean? So this is a component, React component. Don't call this use state hook inside the loops. We should not call the hooks inside of the loops, inside of any of the conditions like this, inside of the nested functions like this. So these all three things are wrong. We should not do these things. So at hook should be at the top level. At any point, hook should be at the top level. Let's show that. I will show the reason why we need to use the hooks at the top level, because this rule is like every time when the component renders, React hooks will see the order. It depends upon the order. Every time the component renders, the same order should be there each time. So with this rule, React will preserve the state of the hooks between the different states. So let me show that with an example. So here I have taken one form. So there is a couple of states have declared, one state, use effect, again use state, use effect, multiple use effect, use states. So let me take an paint to example this. Yep. See here, hope you can see this. So here I have used one state. So React don't know whatever the state variable or what you are doing with that state. So it will not have any idea about what it is. You may have used use state, use effect, use state. So you have used the continuously like this, but React will not have no idea regarding these things. Internally, what the React does is it will create a box, array like structure box like this, and it will give a number like this. So for each, every use state, use effect, it would be given like this numbers. So it depends upon the order of the component render. So with that, the React can preserve the state. It can understand what state it needs to give at this one number. What state it needs to return at two number. It know only these things, 1, 2, 3, 4, these things. So that's the reason React will be expecting the order. It depends upon the order. Every time the component renders, the order should be the same. It should not vary at any point. So 1, 2, 3 like this. So here it is fine. So let's take the second example. Why we are saying that React should be on the top level. It should not be given under any condition, loops or nested. So let's say here in the second, I have taken one if condition and I have used use effect. So now this condition may be true or may not be true. For one component render, this condition may be true. But for another component render also, this should be true. At any of the component render, the React order should be the same. So sometimes if this if was failed, so if this condition is not executed, it will not go inside this use effect. So then what happens? So here the order would be like continuous boxes, like one, it would be created one. So here two was missed. So in the third position, it will be given two. In the fourth position, it will be given three. So here what you are expecting, so it will try to pick the surname. But it can't pick the surname in this third use state, because here the two means the use effect. It will try to replace this use effect at this point here. Here it will try to replace the use effect. In the second position, it will try to replace the use effect. But here you are expecting the surname. So that's the reason it is breaked. So again, in the third point also, if one hook was breaked, all the hooks would order would be breaked. So that's the reason hooks, while using hooks, the order is very much important for component renders. So now here, if you see, the box stored is three, but here in the three, it is giving the surname. But here you are expecting some use effect document change. Here you will be getting three as surname, but you are expecting some use effect change where it will lead some miscellaneous errors. So that's the reason the order is very much important while you are working with the React hooks, because React has no idea about what's the variable we are using, what the hook you are using, what the use state we are using. To preserve the states, it will maintain the boxes, continuous array-like structure boxes like this. Based upon that, for every component re-renders, it will assign those values accordingly. So this is all about the first rule. So hope you understand that. So whenever you are trying to give like this, you should not give if like this. So instead that, you need to use the use effect below. So I have used the conditional statement like this. Instead that, you should use inside of the component render. So this is the right thing. You should not use the conditional statement above on the top level. So that's the reason we say that use the hooks, call the hooks at the top level. So now we are calling the hooks at the top level. Inside this hook, you can use the conditions, loops, anything you can use inside this hook. So this is all about the first rule of the hook. So coming to the second rule. So what does this rule says? Call the hooks from the React functions. So you should not call the React hooks from any regular functions. Like, let me show that with an example. You need to call the hooks from React component itself. You should not call it from the regular functions. With this rule, what React does is it will maintain all the stateful logic in a component. Let me show that with an example. So here is the second rule. So I will show this with an example. So here, this is a normal function. This is a normal regular function. And this is a React component. What's the difference between these things? First of all, regular function doesn't return any of the JSX. In React, we call a component if it returns a JSX. So now we are returning some JSX. So now this can be called as a React component or a React function. Whereas this is a normal function. We should call and we can call the hooks only from the React components. So in that way, you can call this function. So use custom hook. So it will execute this component. Here, as the state changes, this will be impacted and the component would be re-rendered again. Again, this component would be re-rendered. So whereas if you straight away uses this regular function and if you're trying to call this hook, so everything happens here, but there won't be any re-renders like this. The code would be messed up. So that's the reason you should not call the hooks inside a normal function. Okay, you only should call them within a React component. So this is all about the second rule. So all the time we may not remember these rules. So for that reason, React people has provided us, let me show you a plugin called ESLint plugin React hooks. So if you install this plugin and if you configure the ESLint configurations like this, this will enforce us to follow these two rules. This will force us to follow these rules. If you are using Create React App by default, this would be there. By default, this plugin would be available for those things. So hope you understand the two rules of React. Thanks for watching. If you have any doubts or any clarifications needed upon any of the topics, please comment that below the YouTube comment. So I will pick that and I will tell in the next YouTube videos. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.